Today is the Maryland Association of Counties Winter Conference, and as part of the conference, the 911 centers in the state of Maryland decided to stage an expo of where we've come to this point in 911 in the community in the state of Maryland. We're actually doing live 911 call taking. We have six counties that are represented from across the state, and we have 911 specialists staged in a conference room utilizing 911 equipment, processing real 911 calls for their counties.
This one in particular was a statewide initiative that started right after COVID. We were trying to find ways that in the event that we had to send staff home to answer 911 remotely, we had the tools and capabilities to do so.
I think if we learned anything in 911 from COVID was that we needed to have alternative options available for us. We always did things the same way, but now we have started to look at other options and other means for us to do the same job effectively, but do it from alternate sites.
This shows the technology that's out there and how amazing it is and what it can do to ultimately save lives across the state and hopefully across the country.
We're utilizing internet as a means of connectivity back to our counties. The majority of the counties in the room today that are there are utilizing FirstNet, the public safety broadband network, which is excellent for us because, as I said, we're in a conference center today. So there are at least 1,500 people in attendance here today. And I can only imagine what it would have been like if we were competing for bandwidth with those same devices. As far as the functionality of the equipment and the task at hand and being able to do their job, they were saying, hey, minimal impact. We didn't have any of our county's participants that lost connectivity at all during the event.
Everything worked right and seamlessly, and the dispatchers in Harford County had no idea I was the one that took the call from 2 hours away. I had no challenges whatsoever today, and I was able to communicate with the dispatchers in Harford County very easily through messaging system that we have within our CAD.
These mobile command posts, or boxes that we call them, are just that. It's a box. It's a phone in a box. It's not a vehicle. It's not a trailer. It's actually, you carry it wherever you go. As long as you have a laptop to set up CAD to take calls, we're good. So we have to have broadband in order to connect to get the phones to remote into our system at our centers. We have to have the broadband to remote into our CADs, so we can bring those up and enter calls. This allows us, should we have an incident, that we would need to vacate our primary center, and if we were not able to move to a backup center, this gives us capabilities to move to another remote location.
Severe weather events, natural disasters, if a PSAP is down, this demonstrates they can go remote. And outside of the pandemic, whether or not we want to talk about remote work, and maybe that is going to be a thing now into the future, and if we're able to demonstrate that this works and it can work well, I think we open up a lot of doors in terms of capability.
In crisis situations or in times where we need to exercise our continuity of operations plans, these are the technologies that are there and available to us to support us. People are astounded at what we're doing in that room. It was a great demonstration of when public safety puts their mind to something, what can happen.